Lord, we bless your God. You are a good God, O God. You are good in the morning. You are good in the evening. You are good at all times. Father, we give you praise. Jesus, we give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. You're only just appreciating this morning. Father, we give you glory. We give you honor, God. We exalt you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, the King of Kings. We bless you, Holy Name, God. What is your name? Jesus, deserve all the praise. What is your name? What is your name? Jesus. Jesus, you deserve all the praise. What is I say, what is your name, Jesus? You deserve all the praise. What is your name?
Jesus, you are worthy of God to receive all the glory. We bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. Jesus, you are worthy of God. You are worthy, O God. You are worthy, O God. Worthy to receive all the glory. Worthy to receive all the honor. Worthy to receive all adoration, O God. We bless your holy name, Jesus. We bless your holy name for the gift of life. That we can stand here today, O God. It's just by your grace, O God. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. Many have gone. Not by their own mistake. COVID-19 has taken some away. Even people don't have underlying issues. Father, we give you glory. We bless your holy name. With the Lord, a shout of praise. What is your name, O God? What is your name, O God? Give a shout of praise. Shout a big hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Take your seat. Thank you, Jesus. I want to just appreciate our mom in the house, the first lady in the house. Mommy, we appreciate you, God. We appreciate the work of God in your life. And Daddy, once more, I'm not taking it as a right to share your altar. Thanks for giving me this honor to be for Daddy to sit down and his son is preaching. I think it's a good thing. Praise. And for those who have been able to make it today, shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the
See,
time.
I don't know. I just feel that I'm already in 2021.
Yes.
And 2021 is not going to be the same like 2020.
Yes.
It's going to be a year of difference. Thank you, Jesus. It's going to be a year that things will happen for you. Things that have not happened before will begin to happen for you. Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know that it's your season, shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know that you are entering a new season of ease and favor, shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said, if you know you are entering a new season of ease and favor, I said, shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the time.
I'm not going to take your time this morning. Just got 40 minutes and I'll be off here. I always want to keep time. I've titled my sermon this morning, New Season of Ease and Favor.
Amen.
2021 will be a year of ease.
Amen.
Anointing of ease will come upon you like never before.
Amen.
The Bible says, for everything, there is a season. For everything, there is a season. And a time for everything. Thank you, Jesus. For receiving, even this will come to pass. 2020 will come to pass. COVID-19 will become a history.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
As long as the Lord liveth.
Yes.
We give you glory, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We give you honor, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Before the foundation of the earth, before you were created in your mother's womb, God had already laid an exact plan for your life. Nothing catches God by surprise. Nothing happens that God does not know. Before you were even formed, before your mother conceived you in the womb, before your mother or your father met your mother met your father, God has already ordained the exact plan for your life. And for that, in that plan also is the anointing of ease will be your portion.
Amen.
You are coming to anointing of ease.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. He said, eyes have not seen, ear have not heard, nor has it gone into the heart of man what God has got in store for us. Yes, 2020 has been rough. But it's not a surprise to God. You are alive today because God has got a plan for your life. You are alive today because you have to fulfill destiny. You are alive today because you have to enter a new season in your life. You are alive today because anointing of ease has to come into your life. You are alive today because you are entering a new season of hope, a new season of increase, a new season of breakthrough. Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your mistake, you may have made mistake through your own choices. But that will not stop what God wants to do in your life. That will not stop the season you are about to enter. That is not going to stop the season of increase that you are going to enter. Yes, we make mistakes in life. Sometimes you find yourself in situation you think that, oh, it's because of your mistake. No. Sometimes these things have been ordained that you have to go through it. But God is a God of mercy. God is a God of second chance. God is a God of second chance, third chance. He said, let us go boldly before his throne of grace. Let us go boldly before his throne that we might receive mercy. His throne of grace that we might receive mercy. So your mistake is not going to even stop what God is about to do in your life in 2021. Jesus, that is you. Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, when you enter into anointing of ease, doors that have not opened before we begin to open. Connections that you didn't have before we begin to happen. The doors will open that no man can shut. If that is you, shout the big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are coming to anointing of face. Time and chances will come together for you. I say time and chances will come together for you. I say it again. Time and chances will come together for you. You will attract opportunities. We come looking for you. You see, when you come into anointing of ease, into a season of favor, you don't need to look for connection. You don't need to look for opportunity. Opportunity will be attracted to you. People will be attracted to you. Doors that have not opened before will begin to open. What you have struggled for with before, you will stop struggling. Shout the big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You will meet people who will lift you up and not pull you down. Father, we give you praise.
Hallelujah.
First Chronicles chapter 12, verse 32 says, and for the children of Issachar, they were men that understand, have understanding of time, to know what Israel ought to do. 1 Chronicles chapter 12 verse 32. Some people are still looking at your Bible. And the children of Issachar, I say it again, which were men that had understanding of time, that had understanding of time to know what Israel ought to do in this season. You have to tone out your antenna. Stay tuned to opportunities. Stay tuned to opportunities. Yes, we go. It's an unprecedented situation that we have. We find ourselves in. But in this unprecedented situation, opportunities are opening.
Yes. Open doors.
So you go to stay tuned to opportunities. And when you are entering a season of anointing of ease, opportunity will look for you. But it's less for you to recognize the opportunity. Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Stay tuned to opportunities. Your story will not be the same.
Hallelujah.
I said your story will not be the same.
Hallelujah.
Your story is going to end in victory.
Yeah.
I said your story is going to end in victory.
Yeah.
Your children's story is going to end in victory.
Yeah.
Your business is going to end in victory.
Yeah.
That job is going to end in victory.
Yeah.
If that is you, shout a big hallelujah. But you got to stay tuned to the opportunities that God is bringing for you. There's a fascinating report that talks about baby locusts and locusts. You know, locusts, baby locusts, they cannot fly. But they can jump 100 times their height. But what do they do? They stay tuned to ride on the wind when the wind is perfect. And that's why I said you got to stay tuned to opportunities. To know that, yes, this is the time. Yes, things are happening. But doors will open for you.
Yes.
Doors that have not opened before you before will open for you.
Yes.
There are going to be doors that no man can shut. Yes. There are going to be opportunities that nobody will take glory. But only God will take glory.
Yes.
Look, because they stay tuned to the opportunity at the right time for them to fly. The same thing with mature locusts. Mature locusts can grow, they can travel miles and miles and miles. But they decide to wait until when the wind is perfect. They wait until when the wind is perfect. So you got your inner antenna has to be turned on. And look at what is happening. I didn't know. I said, what is the opportunity that I can find in this situation? The locusts don't have the greatest dynamic at all. But they know when to stick to ride on the wind. The wind of God is blowing your direction.
Yeah.
I said the wind of God is blowing your direction.
Yeah.
You are about to come into a shift. I said you are about to come into a shift. The wind that has blown against you before, we blow for you in the mighty name of Jesus. The wind that has blown against your children, we begin to blow for them. The wind of God is blowing your direction in the mighty name of Jesus. The wind of God is blowing the direction of your business in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, it says not by might, it's not by power. It's only going to happen by the Spirit of God. When the wind of God is blowing in your direction, when the wind of God, when it's your time, when you enter that season of ease, when you enter into that season of favor, you think that because you have a know-how. No, because it's just your time. It's just your season. 2021 will be your season of breakthrough.
Amen.
2021 will be a season that everything you touch will prosper.
Amen.
2021 will be a year that God will turn around things for you.
Amen.
Everything that you have lost, God will refund it to you.
Amen.
God will bring you out of every struggle that you are going through. He's not going to just bring you out. He will bring you out better and greater than what you have been.
Amen.
So let us stay tuned to opportunity for what God is about to do in our life. You see, when the wind of God is blowing your direction, sometimes I try to make effort and go for a run. When it is windy, when you are running against the wind, you struggle, you open your mouth. When you are running, you are not supposed to open your mouth when you are running. You are struggling. The same for those of us who have traveled on air, when the wind is blowing in the direction of the plane takes time, the pilot takes time, you arrive. So when the wind of God begins to blow in your direction, when things begin to happen, what will have taken you 10 years, you see that you are doing it in 1 year. The word that you would have contributed, you are gathered in 10 years, you see that it's happening for you. If that is you, shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good. You are coming into an acceleration.
Amen.
What will take you 10 years will take you 2,000 times. Because God is blowing His wind in your direction. Because you are entering a season of ease. Give God a shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
What you have struggled with before, you will not struggle with anymore.
Amen.
All it takes for the last to be the first, thank you, Jesus. All it takes for the last to become the first is the wind of God to blow your direction, and you begin to accelerate like never before.
Yeah.
And that's what happened to David. That's what happened to David. When they were going to Jesse's home to anoint the next king. See, we look at facially, but God look at your inner mind. The firstborn king looks handsome, physical. It was just what you were looking for. And you think, oh yeah, that should be the right king. But David was in the shepherd's bush. Even his father did not even consider. They are not, the oil did not flow. They had to ask, yes, say, have you got any other? So he said, yes, there's one behind here. It was just the season of David.
Hallelujah.
The wind was blowing in his direction. He said, bro, go and bring him. As they tried to anoint him, the oil flew. Your oil will flow.
Amen.
I said, your oil will flow.
Amen.
Your oil will flow.
Amen.
All it takes is for God to breathe in your direction. Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible said, the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. The expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. So every time you are having a dealing with God, you have to, your expectation have to be high. God will only meet you at the level of your expectation. If you think things are not going to happen, if you think that it's a hard year, it's going to be a hard year. If you think that 2021 is going to be like 2022, it's going to be like that. Your expectation, you got to say, the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. God will meet you at the level of your expectation. If you don't expect anything, you will not go forward, you will not increase. You'll be stuck in a rut. So as we are entering this year of 2021, the year of ease, the year that God will open doors that no man can shut, the year that God will bring connection, you've got to believe that it's not your doing, that it's God that is going to do it. Give God a shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
It's easy to get stuck in a route when you don't expect anything. And when you don't expect anything, you don't grow. When you don't expect anything, you don't move forward. Yes, you may have prayed for something, it didn't happen. It's not because God has forgotten you, no. It's not because he doesn't want to answer you, no. It's not because God doesn't like you, no. Sometimes it's because those who are going to be with you in that journey are already. And sometimes God doesn't want to answer because he has got better things, bigger things. So when you pray, it doesn't happen. You say, all right, God, I understand. I'm moving forward. You've got bigger things. If one door closes, a better door, bigger door we open for you. As you go into 2021, don't look at the cup as half empty. Always look at it as half full. And you see, that is where you that means you are taking your level to the you are taking your expectation to the next level. If it doesn't happen now, God has got a bigger thing. Say, all right, God, I understand. You got big, better things, bigger things. Shout a bigger than me. God is a God of increase and not decrease. I say that again. God is a God of increase and not decrease. God never wants us to go backward, only forward. Don't say, oh, but it was God that blessed me. God knows what he's doing. He's our source and our sustainer. He's a progressive God. This make me remember when I was preparing this sermon. The story of Hezekiah in the Bible. This guy was sick. He was going to die. And he seeked the face of God. As Prophet Isaiah said, what has God in store for me? Am I going to die? They said the disease was similar to what you call shingles today. And if you can imagine, science wasn't as good as it was, as it is today. Thank God for those, for people, the brain God has given. See, I'm not against science. I did science in school. Yes, there's all conspiracy. We thank God. It is God has given these people the brain to be able, if God is going to work wonders, he's going to use human beings. Yes. Thank God for the scientists. Thank God that solution is coming. For solution to come, that, hey, Jesus, that means there's a better tomorrow. Amen. There is a better tomorrow. Amen. Because if God has not given them the wisdom and the knowledge, it will not happen. It's the first time it has happened that within a year, it takes for a vaccine to be found, to be established, it takes 8 years. But we thank God for God has given us brain. Let me know that word. We give God the praise, we give God the glory. A better year is ahead of us. So this guy was sick. So no doctor then. Sick in the face of God. As I came, he said, what has God in store for me? He said, what he was expecting is that God is going to say, you'll be healed, you'll be set free. Before God goes there, I read it the exact way he says in the Bible. He says, set your home in order. You are going to die, Jesus. Imagine, if any prophet says that today, they'll say, well, why are you sick? Are you sure you're not been drinking? Are you sure? He said, set your house in order. You are going to die. That was not what he was expecting. That was what not he was expecting. And that is why sometimes when you are expecting something and it don't happen, God has got a better thing. What did this guy do? He did not give up. He turned to the world, cried to God. He said, God, I'll be faithful. I'll be faithful in your house. I've paid my tithes, oh God. I've not forsake the assembly of each other. I am always there. Have mercy. Have mercy. Have mercy. Before Isaiah even left the place, God sent him back. And that's why I said God is a God of increase and not decrease. God could have said, okay, I give you 2 years to set your home in order. God did not give him 2 years. Did not give him 3 years. Did not give him 5 years. Gave him 15 years. 15 years to put his house in order. But Isaiah could do that. Because he can recount what he has been doing in the house of God. He can recount that. You see, sometimes when you say the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Agitenos, sometimes we not just say these things. It's because of the work these people are doing, because God has answered them before. They can answer God with the same God we answer you. So he pleaded his case. Can you plead your case? Can you look at yourself? If you, yes, God is a God of victory.
Can you plead your case before the King of Kings? God, I'll be faithful to your house. God, I've not forsaken the assembly of each other. God, I'll be only be there when they come. Before Zion left, God said, change. See, God is not a pity party at all. No. It's not your tears, it's not your cry. Those are emotional things. But when you're able to say, on the mountain, God, I trust you. In the valley, God, I trust you. God will look at you and increase you. It could be your business that is struggling. You say, God, you give me this business. It could be your children that are not behaving. God, you gave me these children. I looked unto you, God. I brought them to you. They were named before you, God. God is a faithful God. He will look back and will answer your prayer. So Ezekiah pleaded his case. You plead your case and you can be justified. He received mercy, you shall receive mercy. You are entering a new season. I say you are entering a new season. A new season of increase. You are entering a new season of victory. In the mighty name of Jesus. You are entering a new season of ease. In the mighty name of Jesus. You are entering, oh God, a season of favor and mercy of God. If that is you, shout a big hallelujah. Restoration is coming your way. Your restoration is coming your way. You are entering a season in your finances. In the mighty name of Jesus. Everything you have lost, everything the enemy has stolen from you, you are going to get back. In the mighty name of Jesus. I say that again. Everything you have lost, everything the enemy has stolen from you, you are going to get back. In the mighty name of Jesus. You will go into the enemy's camp and take back what he has stolen. You truly will go into the enemy's camp and take back what he has stolen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Shout a big hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good.
Amen.
Psalm 66 verse 12 says, we went through fire and flood. But you, God, thank you, Jesus, not yourself. But you, God, brought us to a place of abundance, a place of increase, a place of prosperity, a place of enlargement, a place of new elevation, a place of new levels of blessing. Something good has to come out of 2020. Something good has to come out of 2020.
Yes.
I read that. It said, we went through fire and through flood. But you, God, brought us to a place of abundance. The number of your days, God, you will fulfill. I said, the number of your days, God will fulfill. The Bible didn't say you will fulfill it, but God will fulfill it.
Amen.
You are not forgotten.
Amen.
Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You may have been through fire. You may have been through flood. But ease is coming.
Amen.
Blessing is coming.
Amen.
Promotion is coming.
Amen.
Promotion, your finances is coming. In your pay packet is coming.
Amen.
It's a promotion come not from the east or from the west, but God, promotion come from God.
Yes,
your business will start expanding like never before.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There's a better tomorrow.
Amen.
God will not only bring you out, will bring you out better.
Amen.
You may have been rejected in the past, but you'll be accepted.
Amen.
I say you may have been rejected in the past, but you'll be accepted.
Amen.
They may have said no before, but you are coming to a yes. You may have been pulled down before, but God is lifting you up. I said, God is lifting you up. God is lifting your children up. God is lifting your business up. Your business will not struggle. In 2021, I said, your business will not struggle. Your children will not struggle. In the mighty name of Jesus.
You must stay tuned to opportunities. Some people, the change is maybe a switch in career. Some people have lost their job. And God knows what he's doing. Maybe it's time for them to switch and go to a better career with a better pay pattern. It may be the time that you see, you look back and say, okay, now this is the time. Now that job is gone, this is the time. Let me move to a new thing. And that new thing that you just said, why did I not move to that new thing? Because you are comfortable. So that's why I said, as you go into 2021, don't look at the cup as half empty. Look at it as half full. See what God is doing in your life. See what God is about to do. See what doors is about to open. You may be sick. Ease is coming to your help. In the mighty name of Jesus. Shout a big hallelujah. Shout a big hallelujah. Shout a big hallelujah. God says he will make your enemy your footstool. Say he will make your enemy your footstool. What has been a stumbling block? What has been an obstacle? God is going to use it to set you up into a bigger thing. In the mighty name of Jesus. You see, what God is going to do is just like when somebody put their leg out to trip you over. Instead of you going down, you went over the trip. The enemy may mean it for evil, but God turns it around. What looks like a stumbling block, what looks like a disappointment, what looks like an obstacle today, God is using it to take you to another level. Shout a big hallelujah. Shout a big hallelujah. Shout a big hallelujah. Every pit the enemy has dug, they will fall into it. In the mighty name of Jesus. My time is fast approach. Finish. Daddy, I'm sorry, sir. Psalm 102 verse 3 says, there is a set time for favor. There is a set time for favor. That's why I said in the first verse, I said, for everything, there is a season. Time for everything. So there's a set time for you to break through. There's a set time for that connection to come your way. So let your expectation, you see, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes we want to bring our own blueprint to God. But God has got a better blueprint. There's a set time for that door to open. It's just like the cripple in the pool of Bethesda. There's always a set time when the angel will come. So there's a set time for you to break through. Amen. Embrace where you are at the moment. And God will lift you up. Amen. Shout a big hallelujah. Shout a big hallelujah. God is good. For all the unfair things that has happened to you, people talking about you, bringing you down, this is your season of vindication. Amen. I said, this is your season of vindication. Amen. People have been talking bad about you, saying this, saying that. God is setting you free. Amen. God is fighting your battle. 2021 is not going to be the same. It's going to be better, greater year for you. The year that doors that have not opened before will begin to open. Abundance is coming. There shall be showers of blessing. I said there shall be showers of blessing. Showers of favor. I'm going to finish with this. We all know the story. Elijah said there was droughts. People were desperate. Like how we were desperate now. We were desperate for that vaccine to come up. We were desperate. It was, what is this? Is the world coming to an end? Is the world coming to an end? There shall be showers of blessing.
Amen.
And Elijah said, I can hear the abundance of rain.
Hallelujah.
Rain is coming. He says it in his spirit. At the time, I can hear them. There was no cloud. Sun was shining. The There was no rain coming at all. Thunder, there was no thunder. But he said, I can hear the abundance of rain. I can see over you, 2021, abundance of rain.
Amen.
Abundance in your finances.
Amen.
Abundance in your health.
Amen.
You may have been struggling with your health, you will not struggle anymore.
Amen.
You will attract opportunity.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
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 You want to pray? Choir, you're just going to help me with this song. And I will not be silent. I will always worship you. And I will just sit here.
Not be silent.
I will always worship you. Lord, we thank you, God. We bless your holy name, O God. We have this confidence. We have this knowing that 2021 is going to be the best year ever.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.